Hi everyone, this is Sampriti and welcome back to the S-Way. This video is going to be a DIY to make a painting for your living space. Well, right now I'm setting up a new space, my first home ever. And to brighten up my living area, I thought that why not to make a painting by myself. Mostly, you guys must have experienced as well, you know, while scrolling some Instagram feeds and going into some, I'm a big fan of this Urban Ladder profile. So on Instagram, Pinterest, you must have come across some living room space ideas which fascinates you, right? So I am into paintings and I love living areas which are brightened up by paintings and all. So I thought that why not just set up my living space similarly, and for that I thought I will make a painting by myself. And I think it's doable, okay, because I'm not a painter, but in Pinterest you can find some doable designs which are doable for you, and you can pick it and you can start painting all by yourself with brushes or even your fingers. It's very easy, it looks good in the end because of the color combination and stuff, so why not? So this video is going to be all about that DIY painting for your living space. Throughout the course of this video, I'll be sharing with you some tips, ideas and tricks that you can use while making your painting, even if you are not a pro painter. Of course, if you're a pro painter, you will not be watching this video. But nevertheless, so I'll be giving you some tips and tricks that might help you get a painting which brightens up your space, looks good, and makes you happy, right? That's what it matters. So yeah, let's begin this video. As you all can see here, it is very easy to look for inspirational painting, right? On Pinterest or Instagram, just go with DIY painting ideas, and you will find plenty of them, plenty of easy ideas. As you can see here, I think some of them we have done in nursery school, right? So it is that easy. Just pick the right color scheme and it will bring the aesthetics to your place and just look awesome. So just pick your doable design and get started with it. For my painting today, I have decided to draw an abstract of Lord Buddha with some flowers. And for that, I have ordered my canvas from Amazon. It is of the size 24 by 56 inches and it is a pack of two. The brand is Pragati Systems, and I wanted a big piece of artwork for my living room actually, as I wanted to have a minimalistic look, and hence I want just one statement piece instead of too many decorative pieces, For colors, I'm using Camelin Kokuryu Fabrica acrylic paints, and I'm also keeping some Rangila Tempera poster colors for a little touch here and there if I feel needed. Also, I keep some marker paints and black pen, just in case if I need them to highlight somewhere at the end of the painting. Begin with drawing the outline of the idea that you have in mind, and then you can fill it in with acrylic paints. However, I have also watched some videos of painters who actually prepare the base with the acrylic paint on the canvas, and at the top of it they draw the outline of the figures they want to draw. However, I'm going with the other way around. I'm drawing the outline of the figures first, but you can do whichever way makes it easier for you basically. Now try to imagine from where the light is coming inside your painting. By this I mean how it is falling on the objects of the painting inside the painting. Depending on this, you can use lighter shades to define the places where light is falling on the objects and darker shades where it is casting a shadow. As you can see in the painting, I'm using lighter green shade on the branches of the flowers where I think light is falling directly, and darker green shades where I think that it's casting a shadow. Similarly, on the flower petals, you can see that I am putting lighter shades at the top of the petals because I think light is falling there, and underneath the petals there are darker pink shades because I think that that is where it is casting a shadow. And that's how you should go about with the colors. Also, it is very important to focus on the details. The more detailed a painting is worked on, the finer it looks in the end. Work on building the color gradient, the texture of the object. For example, in this painting, I am working on the texture of the flower petals. I am using smaller size brush and building the texture of it with minor strokes with different color gradient. The features on the Buddha figure, that is where I will focus. So this is how one should focus on details to make a fine painting. If the painting you are making is a simple one, say with simple objects which does not have much of detailing, then the best thing one should focus is on the color scheme for it. Bright colors is what in the end brings a difference. Highlighting. Yes, another important thing in a painting is highlighting the features in the painting, where you just not want to beautify it but also want to bring attention of the viewer. Well, you can use black, white or any suitable lighter or darker shade to highlight and enhance a specific part of the painting. In this painting, as you can see, I'm using black and white to define the features on Lord Buddha's face. Also, I'm further going on with golden color to enhance all the features of the painting, and I think in the end it is giving a very polished look to my painting. And here is the final finished look of my painting. I'm calling my painting Atma Dipo Bhava. Well, when Buddha's disciples asked him in his last days, who will guide them after his death? Then Lord Buddha said, Atma Dipo Bhava, which means be a light unto yourself. When I placed it in my living room, every time I walk in and every time a guest walks into the room, nothing but happiness and warmth is what they feel, what I feel.